What's up, guys, and welcome to another episode of Downtime with AZ. My name's Taylor.
I'm Lauren.
I'm Lily.
I'm Christania.
I'm Rose.
And I'm Alana.
And we'll be talking about what's the definition of cheating.
Yes.
Does cheating mean you don't love, like, that the person doesn't love you?
Yes, because you don't respect me enough to stay loyal to me. If you cheat, in my eyes, you don't love me enough. You don't have the respect for me. Mm-hmm. You don't even respect yourself.
Ooh.
So that's true, because you made me a promise. You promised me, getting into this relationship, you shall not cheat. And what did you do? You broke that promise.
True. Question. Sorry to cut you off there. That note. When you say promise, when we got into a relationship, then of course you would think, okay, cool, no cheating, boom. But there was no promise, there's no ring, there's no nothing. If that's the agreement, if you know I'm monogamous, you need to be monogamous because that's what I'm entering. For you to not cheat, I'm so sorry, I have to agree with Lily. That means you don't respect me.
That's true.
Like, because you know, as soon as I know that you've cheated, you've upset me. Would you really want to upset someone that you love?
Yes.
Okay, can I say
would
something?
Would you?
Ask the question,
of course not.
Exactly.
Of course not.
But the question is, does that mean, so you're telling me, say, we're in a relationship, I love you dearly, you know I love you. Something, I slipped up.
If you're in a proper relationship, you can't slip up. You wouldn't cheat. But if I understand where it's coming from, if you're in this relationship, you stay in this relationship, then you're really in a relationship.
Then why are you in it in the first place?
So the question then is, are you saying that people aren't pressured into relationships?
Okay, people are.
Whoa! Hold on.
Oh,
pressures, right?
Jesus Christ.
You have a choice. Uh-huh. You're not strong enough to say no. So why are you even getting into a relationship in the first place? If you're easily influenced for someone to be like, you need to do this,
and then no, and then you want to cheat and then come back over
there. I'm not a relationship. I tell everyone who I'm dealing with, listen, just let you know, I'm not emotionally ready for a relationship.
That's how it should be.
Because you need to respect yourself, and more importantly, respect the other person to do that. Know what I mean? I wouldn't get into a relationship now knowing that I'm not ready. Mm-hmm. And I tell them straight, by the way, you could do what you want, I could do what I want, but
because
if you can't handle that, here's the door, like, I have no problem. But if I am ready, just know there's never going to be cheating.
Yeah, of course.
And if you do cheat, you know.
Yeah, is that our brick tea?
Thank you for
it. I'm not upset.
So I feel about
situations
when you're actually seeing someone and then they're still doing their own thing and then they're like, but you can't do anything. And
I can't believe that you slept out on me.
Even double standards.
That's just
wait, hold on. Before I say what I'm gonna say, let me get this clear. So you are seeing somebody.
Yeah.
Mm. So it's you and it's them. You're both seeing each other.
Exclusively.
Ah.
Okay, I'm getting to it.
So you're both seeing each other.
Uh-huh.
Keyword. Seeing.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? That's the keyword. The keyword is seeing. You're not in a relationship.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're not committed.
Exactly.
You ain't even exclusive.
That's correct.
Exactly. So if you go and do your thing,
they
have no right on these God's green earth to say anything.
Because
you are what?
But
keyword
seeing.
You sound like a pastor just then.
I have previously been in situations with people where we're seeing each other. Maybe that's my fuck buddy. Maybe I'm seeing this one. Maybe I'm just chatting to this one. So it's like nobody has no rights in saying anything because at no point did anybody mention the words exclusive.
That's true.
If you don't mention exclusive, if I do my tip, don't touch
it. Can I ask you a question?
Don't touch it.
So you see, if you're seeing exclusively, you're not together,
yeah,
but you're seeing each other, like she's only dating you.
Mm-hmm.
What about cheating then?
No, no, you agree.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Do you know what? In that instance, mm-hmm, if I'm seeing somebody,
mm-hmm,
and we are exclusive,
mm-hmm,
and because I've actually been in that situation, we're seeing each other, we're exclusive, and the other person's actually seeing somebody else,
yeah,
then at the end of the day, what you said to how our whole exclusiveness, mm-hmm, was fuck you. That's right. What you said. That's right. What you told me.
Right.
Like, you
right.
told me where you told me.
Yeah.
Not I told you.
Yeah.
You we're told exclusive. Me that. But yeah, what you did in actual fact is we're exclusive, but I'm going to do what I'm going to do. And then I cheated. And this fuck you. Because I didn't even tell you. I didn't even have the guts to tell you this is what I'm doing.
True.
So in that instance, you haven't cheated, but you have broken
a bond
or true. Sort of mind that you've got.
But this is not what cheating is anyway.
No,
no.
Because you committed, you still made some form of commitment.
Say exactly.
It's
a commitment, and that means you've broken that commitment. So in a sense, it's not directly cheating, but it's
in a way it is. Yes, in a way it is. In a way it is. Yeah, in a form, in a way, it actually is cheating, but I wouldn't see it as high as a form of cheating.
Yeah. Okay, I'll still be upset. Yeah. So we're talking about seeing people exclusively, we're not talking about relationships.
Well, right now, yes,
right now.
Okay, boom. So what would you define as cheating? I'm seeing you, me and Rose are seeing each other exclusively, we're not seeing other people.
Okay.
So how am I cheating on Rose? Rose is not my girlfriend.
Because why you not saying
that's what I said. What's the definition?
Because why are you going by?
Say you and Rose are dating, right?
Yeah.
But you've been talking to someone, as in before you guys were exclusive, right? You were talking to someone from beforehand.
Nice. Playing
they So now they pop up and they're like, oh, you know, I know we haven't spoken in a while, blah blah blah. I want to take you out for dinner like I promised you. But you're not, there's no, you're my girlfriend. You just see each other exclusively. But you were feeling this person before Reels got
married. Okay.
What are you telling me?
Probably not going to dinner with this person.
Why are you not going to dinner?
Yeah, because I'm seeing Reels exclusively.
That's what I was going to say. It's just dinner though. What if it's just dinner?
It's not because of their intentions.
If you go to this dinner, you cheated.
How have you cheated?
How?
If I'm
difference between what,
being exclusive and in a relationship. So I'm exclusive, right? I'm not necessarily giving my all as I would do in a relationship. Like, mm-hmm, when you're in a relationship, you're building up to something, mm-hmm, massive. Mm-hmm. When I'm in a relationship, I'm thinking take time. When I'm exclusive, like, we're just not there yet.
Mm-hmm.
We're nearly there, but we're not at a relationship. We're not at, this is it, I want to be with you. Exclusiveness, like, we're there, but we're not. And exclusiveness, you could easily just... That's it. Yeah, with relationship, that takes time. When I'm in a relationship,
that takes time
to build. Exactly. I ain't just dropping off like that. With exclusiveness, we're like together, but I could easily just drop off, you know what I mean? It's just like the halfway between a relationship and exclusiveness.
Mm.
But that's why I'm saying, if you do something else, it's not cheating, but it's very disrespectful.
So, I have been exclusive with somebody previously.
Mm.
But where I was exclusive with her, so I was exclusive with her in this sense of we were fuck buddies.
Okay.
The homie turned fuck buddy out of nowhere type of thing. We had an arrangement. Our only arrangement was, if I'm fucking you, then we're fucking each other. If you want to fuck somebody else, let me know, then we're going to stop doing what we're doing. But she then knew that she came into the picture of me chatting to somebody else. So she was like, that's fine, you lot can continue talking together.
As long as
you don't do what you lot.
Okay.
Like, if you're gonna go to that level, let me know. And then I started talking to a third person who actually ended up being my girlfriend for 4 years.
Great.
So then it's like, you have your arrangement. So that's like, for my exclusive title was that we had a clause to what it was we were exclusive about. You can do that when you're exclusive, but when you're in a relationship, you can't do that unless you're in an open relationship.
Exactly.
So for me, personally, there is a difference, because my exclusive was to one thing, whereas the relationship was to the whole everything.
So,
I'm not ready for a relationship.
Okay.
Yeah. But what I have with you, I'm loving, right? Yeah. But right now, I don't want that title.
Right.
Because okay. I'm not ready for those type of responsibilities. Hold on, hold on. Because a relationship, when I get into a relationship, it means I'm going to be with you forever.
Because think about it. I understand what you mean because I'm
listening
about
relationship.
No. Because this is the thing. For a lot of girls, especially, you know, when you're too much emotions and all that, what happens is when you're getting into a relationship with someone, you don't want it to be a short term. No one expects relationships to be just like that. So, but I think the respectful thing to do is tell the person, listen, I do like you, but I think I don't want to be in a relationship right now because I don't know if we're forever. If they agree, do you tell them that or do you just leave them?
No. I'm very honest. I am very honest, right? I am that type of girl who like, I'm going to be honest with you.
I'm investing in you. Going because you pissed me the fuck off. You're not going to do that. You're going to take your time and you're going to come back and you're going to resolve that. And I know some people don't have those good coping mechanisms or they don't know how to communicate and they end up cheating. Now, to me, you've now made that situation worse because now you've added more shit to the pile. How are you going to overcome that? Because when you cheat, you've destroyed trust, you've destroyed respect. How's that person now supposed to lay back down with you? Because when you lay back down with your partner, they're thinking, you start thinking all these extra stuff. It's different from when you're just exclusively dating someone. Now I'm still gonna feel disrespected as hell it's still a commitment that we've made.
Yeah.
But there might be a small chance that we can overcome that because we haven't made that proper commitment.
Would you break up with someone because they cheated on you? Wait, can I say something though?
No, I have to. Yeah. The only reason, because I've been in that situation before, and I thought, you know what, I do love this person, and I genuinely
but do. But they're trying to change.
I'm
so sorry. But it's not about you. It's about me. I can't let someone disrespect me like that.
This is the thing.
That
I'm so big on disrespect.
Taylor.
I'm being devil's advocate, guys. I'm not a cheater.
What are you saying? You're asking like if you would stay with a person if they cheat on you and you're in a relationship.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There is no way that you should stay in a relationship with someone that's cheating.
It wasn't physical though.
Babe, what?
What are you doing?
That's even worse.
So guys, which one do you think is worse? Emotional or physical cheating?
Emotional.
That's the question.
Emotional.
Definitely emotional. 100%. I think emotional. Okay, love chill. Emotional, definitely, because that's like in your feels. Cheating physically, it could be like one night stand.
No, but I actually feel like physical cheating and emotional cheating are just as bad as one another because they both feed into each other. That's what I believe. Because, okay, fair enough, you might have had a one night stand with someone, whether you know them or not, they're still going to be having flashbacks. No, you can be having flashbacks.
I don't remember their name.
You said that you don't remember the name.
But if it's a one night stand, I don't even have your number.
Not necessarily. Sometimes it's like, okay, what if it's a person that you do know, but they're not close to you?
Uh-huh.
They're just someone that's you've known for a while, but it's like, oh, when I go to an event, you see that person.
Mm.
And then for some reason, this one occasion, something happened. Now you kind of know that person, and it's not you know them on an emotional level like that. It's you might know their name, you know a little bit about them, but because now you've entered that physical realm with them, I still feel like me personally, I believe in soul ties and a spiritual connection. You could be starting to feel a way, you know, like oh, and then you start having flashbacks. They might do something that your partner doesn't do. You're still cheating. You cheated physically. Now you're cheating emotionally, and that's how physical led to emotional. And even with emotional cheating, you're thinking about someone else, whether it be an ex, whether it be, I don't know, Beyonce, I don't know, whoever, man. And
that's my favorite example, actually.
You know what? I'm having sex. I want to have sex with this person, as I think it would be amazing.
Beyonce,
you physically do it.
Jay-Z cheated on Beyonce.
Yeah,
He admitted to it. He's cheating on her.
Yeah, that's bad.
Whether it be emotional or physical.
That's bad.
Wait, it is.
But what did she do?
She sang her money about it. She made money. She got her children. Did that take away from her his love for her or her love for him?
Now, you see, the thing is, people have so many different definitions of what they feel like love is. Now, I feel like love is a very personal thing. My personal definition of love may be completely different from yours. Now, with me, respect 110% comes into love.
I'm so sorry.
Now, if I feel disrespected, I am going to question your love. Okay, and that is full stop. Okay. Now, if you cheat on me, I'm questioning your disrespect, your respect for me.
Okay.
Hands down. My love for you, it will wither. I'm so sorry, because I just feel like, you know what, I still do love you, but I can't respect you as much as I did because I feel so disrespected by you. And that's how I personally feel. Mm. Respect and love, I feel like they kind of go hand in hand. Just like affection or being compassionate, that goes into love. Being caring, showing affection, all these things make up love. Love is not just love is bam. Love is made up of so many different components, and when you start taking away, I'm gonna take away this, I'm gonna take away that, people are gonna start pushing your love for them, and that's my opinion personally.
So we have a question for you guys. What's worse, emotional cheating or physical cheating? Make sure you comment down below. Also make sure you like, share, and subscribe right here, and we'll catch you guys later.